Hello, hello, and welcome back to Cars of Glasgow. And today we're going to be taking a look at the 2019 Lexus RC300h S-Sport Takumi. So stay tuned for this video. The Lexus RC has had a minor facelift for 2019 to keep it competitive with its rivals such as the BMW 4 Series, Mercedes-Benz C-Class and the Audi A5. At the front of the car we've got the new LED daytime running lights that are integrated now into the front cluster. We've got darkened rear tail lights that have the L shape going on. Being the RC300h, it's still powered by a 2.5-litre 4-cylinder petrol engine. This car produces about 220 horsepower and it's driven through a CVT automatic transmission and it's rear wheel drive. The car is currently weighing in at 1.7 tonnes and that gets the car from 0 to 60 in 8.6 seconds. And with a top speed of 118 miles per hour, the car achieves roughly 47.5 miles per gallon officially and produces 114 grams per kilometre of CO2, that makes it good for company car buyers. The trim has also been jiggled around in the RC lineup. This is to bring it in line with the new ES, NX and other Lexus models. So there's an entry level RC version, a sportier RC F-Sport and the most luxurious Takumi model. The RC base model starts around £38,000 and gets 18-inch alloy wheels, adaptive cruise control, lane keep assist, automatic high beam and traffic sign recognition, while the F-Sport gets a mesh grille, adaptive dampers, LED headlights, orange brake calipers, and to top it all off, the Takumi edition adds all this in along with a Mark Levinson sound system, some extra safety kit, along with the sunroof. This particular RC is finished in Slonic Red, however there are exotic colours available such as Solar Flare, Naples Yellow, and if you want a more tame colour we've got colours like the Azure Blue, F-Sport White, Slonic Titanium which is one of my personal favourites, along with Graphite Black and Mercury Grey, so there's a colour for everyone. So if we start off with the front of the RC, we can see in the F-Sport trim we've got this Lexus's famous spindle grille. Because it's 2019 model we've got the upgraded LED lights which have been facelift, so instead of the previous unfacelift it was a separate LED bar, it's now integrated into the light cluster, and we've got the LED dots as you can see into the headlight unit. Overall the car's very aggressive stance and it makes it look very mean from the front. On the alloy front we've got quite nice high polished almost chrome effect alloy wheels. These are 19-inch and as you see it's got a kind of an orange colour brake caliper Lexus printed onto the side of it. F-Sport logo on the front fender. And I quite like these three-tone wing mirrors, they've got black, chrome and red. And just like the previous Lexus, we've got the little Vortis kind of generator here to reduce wind noise around the windows. Along the side of the car we've got the hybrid badge. Signify this is a hybrid. Over into the rear of the car. Quite a handsome rear end. I quite like these rear lights and the fact that they kind of jut out from the bodywork. A bit of origami going on with the complexity and the shape of them. Some fake vents down the side because that's all the rage. Got two twin exhausts, one at each side, which I kind of got a tip with the exhaust inside it. On the rear, we've got the Lexus badge finished and highlighted in blue, and we've also got the blue 300h to signify it's a hybrid again. So to open the boot you can get the fob out, there's two ways, you can push the button or you can hold the fob down. You've got that gentle glide motion. You've got a very similar boot size to the IS300h, it's a very large and wide and it's not actually too bad. This particular car is fitted with the rubber mats, so you're not going to scratch up the interior. Again you've got the little L emblems embossed all throughout the mat. Pretty decent sizing, you can see you've got split folding seats, 60-40 split, if you wanted to fold it down. quite a light action on the boot lid.
And you've got your wee camera there if you want give them a wee clean.
So that's the exterior of the car. I think it looks really great in this red colour. Especially in the sunlight, you get hints of kind of like gold. Quick step inside the car. Just put in the brake and push the power button to start the car up. Being a hybrid, that's it. Using the batteries and it's very silent. We've got a cool infotainment display. What's this logo going on? They're quite like the clock in Lexus cars, they're quite nice analog clock, you don't always see that in everyday cars. And then we've got, same as the IS, you run your finger across for the touch sensitive buttons, for the climate controls. All this is basically the IS, the same kind of layout. Got your heated steering wheel, heated and cooled seats. And then over here you've got your knob for your left to eco mode, all your way to sport. And that also changes the tachometer, so if you see that again, eco. And then sport, and it kind of gives you an LFA inspired dial with a red line up there. While we're on the purpose of the entertainment here, you push little kind of three squares on the steering wheel, that actual bezel moves. So that's quite a cool feature in the F-Sport Lexus cars. And on the left here, as you can see, you get your driver's information, so like fuel range, miles to a gallon, etc. G-force reader, you can go sat nav, your music, actually lane departure warning, safety systems. I quite like it centred in that kind of configuration. Over on the right hand side, your kind of parking sensors you turn off, your blind spot monitoring, your boot release, your trunk release. Or in your bonnet release there. You set your trip computer, automatic lights, stuff you probably won't really touch. You've got your preset driver seats over here. And as you can see, everything's electric, so you've got your seats in the steering wheel or electric mind mothers. Doors lock and unlock, and then you've got your soft closing windows. You can kind of see this, but it's hard to see, but the glass on the passenger side and the driver's side doors are a little bit different from the clear glass in the front. It's kind of got an orange or a kind of amber hue to it, to a bit of, you know, I would say UV protection. Over the door sills here, we've got nice quality leather throughout. As you can see, you've got nice deviated stitching in the white, and it all flows rather nice, and you've got this kind of stamped aluminium here for a bit of detail. This car is fitted with the Mark Levison sound system. That means you get the nice speakers all around, and you've got Mark Levison subwoofer in the back, along with a little speaker grill up here. Right, we'll move on to the seats in the RC. They're very, well, this particular one being the F-Sport, they get the big sporty contoured seats. They've got good bolstering, good thigh support, and as mentioned before, they are ventilated and heated. And the leather quality is really nice and supple and soft. Got a little bit of storage under here, where you can put your USB and your auxiliary cable. It's a great lighter if you so wish, or a 12 volt outlet. Decent sized cup holders in the middle there. That is the only cup holder, but it's a little bit limited in the storage, the driver door bins. And your typical Lexus EV mode, traction control off and snow mode to limit slip when you're on, I guess, an icy road during winter. We also in this car have the Lexus trackpad, so it replaces the kind of little wheel we had in the IS. And that allows you to quickly see, to move across. It's a little bit faster, I would say, than the pad, the little mouse, but the pad is a little bit difficult to use when you're driving, just to try and see exactly what button you want to click. Everything else is kind of generic Lexus, so you've got your volume control, change your radio or your CD track here. Phone buttons on the left here, then the right allows you to switch through things in the centre screen. And then here's your lane departure and your forward collision assistance and the kind of what we call radar cruise control. Flappy paddle gearbox, which I do quite like to use in the CVT as step simulation, but it's quite a nice feature. Oh, quick little mention here, you might notice the rear vents have got this kind of silver bezel around it. Very similar to the IS, except what Lexus have done, have put the silver bezel kind of about a third of the way up and then pushed it protruding. Instead of going all the way around, this can make it a little bit of a different detail. But the overall dash design is the same as the IS. And the facelift also includes the stitching now around the side of the climate control instead of it was before it was protruding out the hard plastic, so now that's all softly enclosed. Good thing your knee doesn't bang against it, it's all nice and soft. And to open your glove box, nice soft damp there. A bit hard scratchy plastic inside, but you've got nice silver trim to highlight that. And just like Toyota Lexus, probably should push that little button there to open and close. So we have an electric sunroof, so you can just push that button for a couple of seconds and it'll do its thing and close up nice and tight. And it is rather quick, and I quite like having that feature. Just having a sunroof is quite nice. I did, at first of all, thought it might be quite small for the car, but due to the cabin where it's angled, you get quite a lot of daylight all the time. We do have a manually operated sunshade. We had heavy thunder and rain yesterday, so I can actually comment on how well the manual sunshade actually sound deadens, I guess, from the glass when the rain hits it really heavy. So that's quite good. Point for Lexus there. Also quite like the frameless mirror up here. It's quite hard to see, but it's rimless. Bit of a kind of nice modern touch. And I've got these touch capacitive interior light buttons. Over on the door we've got these little magnetic leather clips that allows you to release the seat belt. So that means when you jump out, you can slide the seat forward and it is electric, so you have it a couple of minutes. And you have got seating for two. I'll move my jacket so you can see. ISOFIX points are just behind those little flaps there, which is nice for child seats, easy to install if you wished. Isn't too much room back there. I'm not going to attempt to jump in just because it's limited headroom and space, but overall, get nice leather seats and padding there for your elbows. And again, because you might lift sometimes, I've got a little speaker back there. Now you join me behind the steering wheel of the Lexus RC, and first things up first, it's one report is how pleasant it is and quiet tone to speak in. If I put this in sports mode right now, but join the motorways if I put it in. You can hear a little bit of the simulation on the country speakers for the noise, because that is all artificial, however it is a bit fun and addictive sort of thing. There's a Ford car in front of us, so we'll move into second gear. And drive. So that's at that motorway speeds, and as you can hear, it's quite stable, but the radar cruise control, you can comfortably set at 60 and just let the car cruise along on the M77 right now. Rather smooth, so the camera's a little bit jumpy on the prop I've got in the glass, the holder for the camera. So yeah, so driving the Lexus RC, what's it like? It's comfortable, it's quiet, it's got all the gadgets and tech that you expect of a 2019 car. As I said, Lexus comes standard with things like the adaptive cruise control, this one's got the lane keep assist, the traffic sign recognition. So really a lot of safety features that you'd expect. It's also got rear reversing camera along with cross traffic alert, so it's quite handy if you're in reverse, where you come out a driveway and someone's coming up your street, it lets you know what indication the car's coming with these yellow lines onto the LCD display screen. So that's quite cool. Driving dynamics, it feels on the road, it's very, very comfortable. You can kind of feel it's designed probably for long motorway cruises. It just seems to be very comfortable, hunkered down. Feels a bit weighty, and especially in comparison to the Lexus IS, which shares a lot of the running gear with. I feel the Lexus IS is a little bit lighter on its feet, and overall, it's a bit more efficient right now. I'm just hovering about 42 to a gallon, and the IS 300h is about, I get about 50 to 52 in daily driving on that. I think the quite like the wee S4 with the package, I quite like that, but also like the fact you've got that gauge, it doesn't get boring just playing around with that and getting that wee bezel moving left and right. But I guess once you've owned this car maybe for a couple of months and stopped showing everybody, that will become a bit more normal. Heated and cooled seats, as I mentioned, the car
lifesaver. Again, that ES has the same kind of button, same kind of feature, just ventilated seats, and usually some cool on a warm, humid day. It's like 20 degrees in Scotland, it's kind of clammy, so that's quite nice. But yeah, the main things I want you to take away from this portion of the video is how smooth and comfortable it is, even though it's lighter and less package. You can only imagine the standard RC comfortable and smooth, just because it was maybe like 17 or 18 inch alloy wheels, instead of probably feeling one 19 inch with low profile tyres. But all in all, it's really comfortable. Car pretty stable. You've got the blind spot monitor, forgot to mention that as well, so that's quite handy. You can flash your yellow indicators when you've got a car on your blind spot. And it's good to go. Quick stop flashing, so that's quite handy as well. What else to mention? Close that up. Manual sunshade, I would say that's a little bit of a disappointing feature in the RC, is the manual sunshade, just because it is quite hard to push back when you're driving. Whereas it's bit, everything else is electric in this car, the steering wheel, the seats, the wing mirrors, just everything. I mean, even the glass panel itself, so I feel like if that was electric, it would be a little bit easier, a bit more kind of Lexus, because that's all the defaults of the car, is kind of keep you comfortable and safe and quiet. Right, but yeah. So while you're on the road, it's a little bit harder to use this like a trackpad. It's the first time experiencing this. I'm used to the little kind of mouse knob in the Lexus cars. The trackpad's a little bit different. It's a little bit more direct, so you can sit touch specifically what you want, but your eyes need to be kind of off the road and onto the brakes to get it. The sound system's pretty good, but I don't want to get copyrighted sued by Jack Jones, so turn that off. I just want to say, hopefully you guys enjoyed this segment of the video, and thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao!
So, I just want to say thanks very much for watching my Lexus RC video, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Please subscribe to the channel below, give it a thumb up, share it with your friends, and check us out on Instagram, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao!